You've been enjoying meeting your many, many fans here today at Comic-Con.
You know, it has been really exciting. I got to say, the character obviously is dear to some hearts, so it's fun for me to meet fans and take that time and take this energy back with me to work and meet fans. I love it. I mean, when I was 5 years old, I was a huge fan of the movies, and the first time I ever even knew what a director was when I looked in the back of the Marvel Star Wars adaptation, and there was a picture of Alec Guinness sitting next to this scruffy bearded guy with a plaid shirt, and I said to my mother, "Who is that? I didn't see him in the movie," and she told me that was George Lucas. He's the director of the movie. He made the film, and that made me think, like, oh, it's not just actors that make the movie, you know, and so there's a whole life that goes into this movie-making process, and I just coincidentally happened to live in the area where those movies were made, near Skywalker Ranch, and as a kid, I always wanted to work there, and it was this mysterious place, and I found a job opening to be a video games tester there when I was 17, and I started there back in 1990, so that was my first entry into working on Star Wars. And George Lucas was never really about pigeonholing somebody in one job, and I got the opportunity to move around in different divisions, and sound was always something I was interested in because it had this artistic nature, and it also has a technical part of it, and both of those two things are exciting for me. So it was a really amazing job to satiate both of those feelings for me. And when George wanted to make more films in the 90s to do the prequels, the technology was a huge part of that, and I got to be part of that drive to do the films in a new way, in this digital way, and so that kind of has become industry standard in the way we make films, and I'm staying out there at Skywalker Ranch and still out there. So it's been a bit of a dream. I'm very happy about it.
Of all the great characters the Star Wars universe has given us, General Grievous is a fan favorite. Why do you think that is? And can you talk a little bit about the performance aspect in terms of particularly the voice? Because it is such a fantastic voice.
You know, Grievous, whenever, you know, characters like Darth Maul, Count Dooku, and Grievous have this role in the prequels to sort of, that pushes the story along. And Grievous was unusual. He was cybernetic. He could use lightsabers. He could have four lightsabers, you know, and so I think that just that part of it alone makes him interesting. You want to know what his story is, where he comes from, and George wanted the character to have an evil flavor, and he had the direction he gave me was more like kind of Bela Lugosi creepy, but also he's a general, so he's got this drill sergeant kind of mentality to him, and he's definitely frustrated at the army that he's been given him, which is kind of ineffectual against Jedi, and so he's got a deep frustration with the Jedi, and I just kind of played it that way. And so it's the character comes from a lower register, so he's more like something like, you know, activate the ray shields and prepare for attack. He's got this deep sort of thing going on. And then as part of being, when I work in the sound crew, I actually have the ability to do some modifications of his voice, and I do some filtering to make him sound like it's the voice is being synthesized out of a cybernetic creature. Same with the battle droids that I play in the show, too. They have this kind of, hello, Roger, Roger. They have this kind of dorky voice, and I just take those and pitch those up a little bit to give them a little bit more of an extreme quality to them. So it's once again, it's my... it's the artistry of performance plus the technical part of how you manipulate the sound. So it's those kind of characters call to me. George wanted the character to have a biological impairment. So he's not just a computer. He's got a cybernetic quality that's also based in biology. So that was the idea of the cough. And then weirdly, sort of a behind the scenes thing there, some of the coughs in the character were actually George Lucas, because during the recording of my performance, he had a really bad cough that day, and my colleague Chris kept the recorder running, and we got some coughs from George Lucas, so we kind of peppered those in there just as a kind of homage to him. So some of those coughs are really nasty, and they were George happened to have a really bad cold that day. But it was also just to illustrate that the character had a biological weakness, and that he, you know, was defeatable. And maybe it was a precursor to the technology that was keeping Vader alive as well.
When you look back now with a little bit of distance, a little bit of time, what are you most proud of in terms of that installment of the saga?
Of Sith, I'd say the completion of that arc was satisfying. As far as on behind the scenes, it was really satisfying to see George finish episode 3 and sort of a weight lift from him after that. He just seemed in a lighter place, and making those 3 movies was really fun for him and the whole crew, and we all enjoyed the experience, but it's also fun to have it be finished. And I think seeing that on his face was something that was good. And still to this day, when I listen to the John Williams music that takes place at the end where Obi-Wan and Anakin are fighting, it's just so tragic, their whole friendship. And also now, thinking back on all the Clone Wars episodes we did that take place before that established their friendship, and then seeing how it all just goes to goes downhill in Revenge of the Sith is hard, and the music just so tragically handles that really well, and I really feel the emotion even now watching it 13 years later. I love working on Star Wars. I've been doing it for a long time now. It's this week it'll be 28 years. Dave Filoni was one of the best things that ever happened to Lucasfilm, and I'm very happy that he's able and has a lot of the original crew back to come and tell more Clone Wars stories. That, for us, is really exciting. When we worked on Clone Wars originally, George was like, let's just do 6 episodes and see where we're at. And at that point, we never changed. We just kept going. We did 100-plus episodes because everyone loved it so much. And having Dave Filoni spearhead this, along with the fans' interest that's been going for 10 years, feels great. And I don't, I saw the reaction at San Diego Comic-Con last week, and it brought tears to my eyes just to see how excited people were for that. And we were a little show on Cartoon Network when it came out, and just the fact that the show's been streaming so much and people have seen it a lot, and people that saw that show are older now, and everyone really just has a soft spot for it. So seeing it come back is really exciting.